Hare Krishna. Even if we can't close the door to temptation permanently, we can close it presently. Sometimes when we have to battle against temptation, at that time we may feel that our urges are so strong. How can we resist them? And how long can we resist them? Even if we can resist them for now. And especially if we start thinking that I have to resist them forever, then we will not resist them ever. Because we think, oh, this is going to be such a struggle, such a torture. I will not be able to do it. So here we need to understand that the struggle has to be seen in proper context. We just focus on the present moment. Is focus on the present battle. Focus on what we need to do right now. Can we resist the temptation now for the present moment? So the word presently can mean right now, and presently can mean in the near future. So right now, for the next 1 hour, for the next 1 day, can I resist temptation? Yes, we can. And that is all that we need to do. The Bhagavad Gita tells us that the pain of resisting temptation is not going to last forever. The pain of striving for purification is not going to last forever. It talks about enlightened pleasures in 18.37, where it states, Yattadagre vishamiva pariname amritopamam tat sukham satvikam proktam atma buddhi prasadajam. So yattadagre vishamiva, that which tastes like poison in the beginning, pariname amritopamam, will taste like nectar in the end. So this means that if we try to connect with Krishna right now, we try to close the door to temptation and turn our attention toward Krishna, who is present in our hearts, whom we can access through the various limbs of bhakti, then for the present is all that we need to do. It may seem like poison now, but that poison is not going to last forever. That poison layer is a thin initial layer. As we become connected with Krishna, as we become absorbed in Krishna, as we start realizing and relishing our own spirituality, then we start experiencing the nectar phase. And thus, we will be able to not only tolerate but transcend the temptation. But if we think that, oh, forever I have to resist the temptation, forever I'll be going through this poison phase, then we will give up in the here and now itself. Therefore, rather than thinking about permanently resisting temptation, yes, we may have the determination that never again am I going to indulge in this. But we shouldn't focus on that intention, especially if it burdens us and disheartens us and makes us give up right now, thinking it's too difficult. We just focus on resisting our lower urges for now, presently. And if we don't just focus on resisting the urges, but on connecting with Krishna, then surely we will relish higher satisfaction and thereby not even notice that the door of temptation is there, or temptation is knocking from outside, because we'll be absorbed and delighting inside. Thank you. Hare Krishna.